Maybe I should start streaming or something. Anyway, let's see.
Armor. Heavy. Patch.
Give everyone heavy armor. The patches are just people's names, probably Kickstarter names, I'm guessing.
No, if you go to the left, you'll get countries. There's Saudi Arabia, for some reason.
Well, I mean, all the names that show up in the patches are probably Kickstarter people.
Yeah. Oh, here's the breaching chart. I'll keep this. Save loadouts. Okay. So, edit loadout. Yeah, I think I've changed it this time. So, I'm good. You got disconnected from the lobby?
Yeah. Just invite me again. Weird. It says server's not. Let me try joining. It says server's not. Oh wait, no. Okay, it found it. Weird. Weird.
Yeah.
So roof or garage?
We had more success with the garage.
Okay. Whenever you're ready.
Go. Co-op. Launch. Now I have heavy armor, so I should be able to survive.
Probably gonna die still real fast anyway. You're all staticky, by the way.
God damn it.
So you survived two bursts instead of one. Right?
Yeah.
Is that the long and short of it? Okay, let me go get myself killed.
And the running animation is the best.
Okay, let's defuse this bomb with a hand grenade. You're not gonna take me alive! I got disconnected from you again. Let me just join on you.
I guess exit doesn't go back to the lobby.
Yeah, nope.
It goes back to the menu.
I told you the menus are bad.
Let me try something. Current loadout. Save loadout. Okay. So if I edit my loadout from the main menu, will it stay? Let's find out. Okay. Where is this? Invite.
I wonder if we'll ever use breaching charges. Haven't found a door where we needed them yet.
You'd have to find a closed door. I wonder if they'd have any effect on the AI.
Salt. Breach. Hey, breach has a shotgun. Let's see if I end up picking breach or not. Nope. So I guess the enemies are somewhat randomized. That guy wasn't there last time. Whoa!
Oh shit.
Okay.
Get him. Who are these beret guys anyway?
The enemies are different depending on the level you choose, which is kind of amusing. So in this one it's apparently Chinese guys with French berets. And in pick a different map and you'll see how it is. Like other maps have like business suit guys and that sort of thing. And the Arctic map has guys in Arctic gear.
If you're moving forward you can't lean.
Well, two of them in there. Oh, he ran away from you. He didn't.
Oh, shit, what?
There were two of them in there because the first guy, you didn't actually kill him. He ran in there with the other guy.
Yeah, that's dope.
Okay, I'm picking breach. I'm going to see how good shotguns do.
it will never allow me to take something different than... Maybe the host is always on recon, I don't know. Advanced settings.
If you want me to host a bit, you'll get lag, but I mean... But you can try that.
So team control... So if I'm the host, is my... you ready?
Yep, ready.
3, 2, 1. Okay, so we can't lean when we're moving.
Yeah. Oh, weird. It was stuck on zero for a while.
I have to be team control if I want to save my life. I don't know why that is. Hey, don't waste ammo, you don't need it.
Yeah, take that. I don't even know what I'm hitting.
Holy hell, you got him.
Whoa!
America's 10 most wanted.
You're hunted, confronted. If only you could kung fu fight the Chinese beret guys.
Not the one by not the one by Black Ops Games, the one by Activision Value.
The first person one. Yeah. Well, I mean they're both for the one that doesn't let you third person kung fu fight Osama, right?
That door doesn't open.
Yeah, it is confusing because one's what? America's most wanted? And then there's America's 10 most wanted? Whoa.
America's 10 most wanted with the fighting is actually called, in the US it's called Fugitive Hunter. But in Europe it's called America's 10 most wanted. Haha! We killed the Revolver Ocelot. Server room. Oh. Fuck.
I really wish there was a place to let us or a setting to let us just spawn all these AI teammates we could take over when we die, like good old Rainbow Six. Thank you, giant floating yellow chevron. Oh no, the screen's flashing red, you've hacked the Matrix.
Okay, so that's two bombs to disarm. Don't imagine.
No, JC Denton.
Oh, fuck.
You cannot go into the bathroom.
Oh, fuck. Oh no, I'll invite you again.
Oh, you didn't kick me out yet, as far as I can tell.
Okay. Let's see.
Feel free to try a new map if you want.
We can do that one. It's we just still have to figure out where the other two bombs are, and we'll have it. We just gotta be careful of like not getting shot. But
trust me, we're probably not gonna finish it. Just saying.
Oh, there's.
Without people to respawn into, if there's no setting for that, it's probably not finishable. I'm just telling you right now. Like yeah. I tried it with the three AIs, so I had three respawns. And I did not do well when I tested it out.
There are different primary weapons to choose from. AK-47. There's like a bunch of stuff.
Yep.
Big. But a lot of them look like variants of M4.
Yep. I'm gonna be a shotgun again. Might as well.
Yeah, it's a close. Go with the. I'll go with the old. Why not? Can't put a suppressor on this. How about the pistol? There's only two types of. Really? Oh, I see. Go with the Beretta. Alright, you ready?
Yep.
Go. At least the loading is quick. And it didn't save my loadout.
Oh, he's not there.
Careful, that room has always had people in it.
Yeah, they can hear us. Well, yeah, I got peeked. If only there were a way to turn the AI reaction time down.
Gotta play this like Doom 2.
I think also I don't get lag powers against AI.
If you can't shoot them through the rail thing.
The railing was definitely absorbing all your bullets.
One guy through the window.
That was weird.
Yeah.
Anyway, trust me, you might want to just try a different map just to see him.
Yeah, I'll do that. Why the hell didn't it save my loadout? Jeez. Or, wait. Switch? Ah, okay. Recon is the one that saved. Yeah. Okay, play host. Go to the other map. Map, headquarters?
Oh yeah, this is the office one. Or office, you know, glass office building looking one.
I'm on recon. Think I'm good. You ready?
Alright. Okay, yeah, I'm good.
Insertion can either be, I don't know, some hallways.
Just take the default.
Or...
Okay. The one that looks pretty.
One. Go.
It's weird how it counts down to zero, at least for me, and it takes then it takes another 5 seconds. Okay, you're looking for Secret Service looking guys. Well, it's all a bunch of hitmen. Agent 37.
Okay, really?
Yeah, told you. It's a really nice looking level though, huh?
Yeah. I guess it might help to have a sniper rifle.
Maybe.
Loadout. Current loadout 1. Let me try and switch it. Sniper. Armor. Heavy. Save loadout. Play.
I think the SASS is sort of a sniper, or a DMR at least. Or maybe that's the LRC.
I'm guessing that there's if you take less damage over a distance, so if we can just engage them at long range, we might have a better chance.
Okay, the SASS and LRC seem to be the snipers. I'm going to use combat optics. Okay, loadout, sniper. There we go. Maybe you've got to go to loadout, then go back first for it to save? I don't know.
If it tells you, I'll try doing that back to the equipment. Wait, one and two are both? Okay, now it's good. Save.
I have no idea what combat optics are, by the way, but it sounds cool.
I think it's from the loadout. It's like if you want a red dot sight. Okay, now, what the hell is wrong with this game?
Oh, no, I don't. I have a shotgun. Oh. Are you dead?
Yeah, they keep shooting through that glass.
Well, they got my leg.
I think that there's some sort of, there's some mislabeling going on because you choose something from the loadout thing, but you're actually choosing something else. So I'll just stick with what I have now.
Okay.
If I have the orb again. What's this?
Yeah, I've got the sniper. We're on the wrong map, but nah, whatever, who cares.
I don't recall choosing biolab.
Oh, the sniper rifles can shoot through this glass, I think. I'm making holes in the floor. Oh right, you can't check the controls, right? Okay, there was a guy who ambushed me down the stairs last time. Whoa! And this time he ambushed me from the door.
I wonder if this game still has text-to-speech.
If only.
Hey.
See, the guy came up from behind you on the stairs.
Yeah, let me just check something real quick.
I think maybe it just selects the thing you picked like 2 times ago. That could be it.
That's really silly.
Yeah, I'm just saying, because like I picked sniper once, and then I was still stuck with Breacher, the shotgun. And then I picked sniper again, and then I finally had sniper. Q and E are lean, except the neurals work. Fire mode is F, by my default controls at least. I assume they're default. I don't remember messing with them really.
Oh, you can toggle lean. That's useful.
I should do that.
I think you'd want to toggle lean and toggle aim.
Yeah, I should do that.
Flashlight. Oh, flashlight is Z. Reaching charge. G. Wait, sprint is run is left shift and sprint is left control. There's two different types of fast movement.
No idea.
All right. Let's see.
Oh, okay, I'll join you. Okay, I'm in. Okay.
This doesn't have full auto. Ah, this is...
Oh, I'm dead.
Oh,
But they can shoot through that glass. Okay. That's how they're killing us.
I can't even see the guy.
Yeah, they can see through that frosty glass, but we can't. And they can shoot through it too.
Alright, play host. Slow down. Can't just slow down.
You know, one thing I gotta admit, this might be kind of fun if you had, like, just a ton of people on here. Filling up all your slots.
Heavy armor.
Looks like you can have up to 12 on a team and 4 spectators, I guess. It's not bad.
HQ, insertion point. It's got a different insertion. Oh, really? When I change the insertion point, it changes the map? Or... what the fuck? Yeah, I don't know what's wrong with this game.
Okay, just, yeah, start it.
Now, if I'm not mistaken, I should have a different gun. I think it's easier to edit the loadout itself rather than have, rather than choose a different loadout. Which is silly, but...
oh hey, I got my sniper now.
Yeah, really, you should be able to move and lean at the same time. This is ridiculous.
No lean and move.
Okay,
oh, hey, this is fun. If you move, it'll just automatically re-lean because it's on toggle. Huh. Okay, let's do this.
Go down.
Black light.
Huh.
Hey, you can swap with their guns.
I think he had a gun. Yeah, he had a gun. Get him. I'd like to. This crosses the courtyard, so there might be more people outside.
Can't go in that door.
What are we doing on this map? Eliminate lead scientist and plant evidence on his body? I thought we were the good guys.
We gotta kill the Secret Service and kill the scientist.
I guess we don't always... that's a nice twist. You're not playing as the good guy.
Whoa!
Oh, shit.
Someone shot me through glass again. It's a guy outside. Just right outside. Anyway, this is a fun map to try, but yeah, it's frustrating. Of course, other maps also have long sight lines, so they can be frustrating too.
Well,
I told you.
I couldn't see
like,
my look.
Yeah. Anyway, you want to try other maps?
I'm quite enjoying this one. Can we try this one more time?
Yeah. Let's do this. I'm never going to get to shoot anyone, even.
So how's the performance on your side?
Oh no, my insertion point might be up top. Oh well. Yeah, it performs fine. I mean, but this is a UE3 game, right? So it's never going to be challenging. I'm just glad my computer hasn't fried itself or anything. Oh, okay, we did spawn here. Okay.
It shows the picture as the roof, but it's actually down because there's some weird lag in the menu. I don't know what it is, but like that's honestly one of the worst things to have in a game like this.
I'm gonna die first.
Just keep it on iron sights or.
I don't even have iron sights, and there's no one in here. Whoa! Two people right outside. I guess you're supposed to, like, open the door from the left side or something. Is that the guy? Objective secure. There's another guy. Look out.
If you press Z, you get stuff, so can just say. But not really.
You got the objective? Huh. Look out!
I'm just saying it.
Secure objective.
Oh, I see. Yeah, it's the auto-talk.
Oh, really?
Yeah, see, the glass... The glass is just,
Like, die hard.
Might as well start up top and, you know, face the bullshit immediately.
Yeah.
See how we can do with snipers.
I don't know if it's...
The map?
Yeah, it reversed back to BioLab. I have the Deus Ex Detroit game in my head. This menu is reminding me of it.
You know what I'm thinking? This is just a theory. But what if, like, making even small changes to the map or whatever resets whatever we picked? So, like, if the map reverts and then you switch it back to the map we want, then like our loadout reverts and you have to pick it again.
And I changed the recon itself. It keeps reverting back to recon, so I just put recon as the guns I wanted.
It looks like looks like I came in downstairs and you're up top.
I'll try to clear this. I don't think I can.
Oh, I can come up top. Hold on.
Oh, yes.
Are you dead?
Yeah, I can shoot from a really far distance.
Yep.
Can you change view?
Actually, we just go a different way and we... Oh. Well, they got me. And we can go right up top, so the other spawn point doesn't matter. They're actually pretty close.
It takes so long, it takes like 3-4 seconds to go back to the main menu and or lobby, and I keep exiting when I don't want to. Let me invite you. It's not an easy game.
It's super hard. And bad, and kind of dumb, but I guess it's unique in that way, right? And it was like free in that weird bundle. Okay, make sure to pick my... Load out. Make sure to pick my insertion point.
HQ insertion point. Rooftop.
Yeah, your mic's definitely having issues, man.
Something wrong with the menu.
Everything's wrong with this whole game.
Yep. Alright, I got a sniper, so... Try and snipe them now. I see, I already see one of them.
They won't see us coming till we strike.
One down.
There's a guy running in, look out.
Two.
Whoa, someone got me. I don't know from where. You just gotta go for it, man. Oh, he's a guy right inside. Shoot the glass twice to break it. Then you can see better. Yeah, he was just inside there, but he ran off to the side. I'm getcha.
Holy shit. Yeah, if I'm fast enough I can kill them, but
okay, I'm gonna spawn in basement again if it'll let me. And then I'll just go take the rear door up. That lets us go up the stairs and it might be slightly better.
Non-lethal takedown is always the most silent takedown. Okay, good.
But anyway, we're police. Okay, so we go up this gray hallway and to the exit. And see, we're right outside of where we start. Whoa, whoa! Okay, last time... Yeah, last time the guy did not hear me and he didn't rush out. They're moving. Where did you go? Are you dead? Oh, you're dead.
Yeah, you shot me first, even though you were like close there, so. There's a guy to the left.
I like a... Whoa! That guy just hitmanned right around a corner, and it's like, no!
Moves over to the closet. I pull up my Beretta. Okay. HQ. Launch. I guess if we move crouched, we won't make as much noise.
I've never tried that, huh? What was the crouch key again?
C.
I'll try that.
It's like pretty slow.
Yeah, it's okay. Oh, right, we gotta go the other way.
Oh, yeah.
Well, this time I was the surprise meat. Oh, I just noticed there's a camera up there. I wonder if, like, that grants them magic spotting ability. You see the camera right up there? Of course, I don't think I was within its field of view, but... Oh hey, it's purely decorative. Great. Okay, wherever we spawn, we're screwed. That's just how this game is.
Yeah, I think going automatic may be better.
Anyway, want to try a different map?
Yeah. Definitely spent way too much time on that. Let's try radar base. And I will change my loadout. Primary weapon. Even on heavy armor, these people are brutal.
I like how the two insertion points look identical. Anyway, this is also a long range map, just so you know. It just has indoors too. As well as long range.
It doesn't seem to matter since they can like immediately spot us and kill us with like SMGs from like 100 meters away.
Yeah, they got bot accuracy.
Oh, I remember this map. So this is the one they were showing off.
Whoa! Holy crap!
was back when I thought the game would be like Unity. Oh, shit. He's on the... the up?
Not sure. Oh, who knows where... Oh, yeah, I see. Yeah, he was... he was far away.
It's not an easy game. Play host.
Might as well just check out, like, the other three maps.
Okay, map. Cargo ship. Loadout. Even on heavy armor, I can't survive.
Yep. With heavy armor, I think, you know, you got a chance to survive one burst, but you're not surviving two. But even then, one burst might kill you, I guess, if it hits near your head. So, whoop-de-doo, right?
And what a time. Okay, cargo ship. Yeah, it's cargo ship, but they show the icon for biolab. CM really loves biolab.
Oh, it shows the cargo ship for me. Weird. How you doing?
Yeah. Is it possible to play versus with boss?
You know, no idea. Is there? There's gotta be a versus here.
There is versus, but I don't know if you can put boss or not.
I'm gonna guess no.
Can you see my flashlight?
Yeah, we can see each other's flashlights. This is UE3, this is not Left 4 Dead. It's pretty cool. You can see mine, right?
Yeah. This is nice. They made a specific dark map. I wonder if enemies can see it.
Probably. I died from the fall. Don't jump down. It's only like 3 meters. I must be wearing way too much heavy stuff.
Goddamn. Send the anorexic police.
So yeah, that's cargo ship.
Still
look at this giant place. It's a Bond villain lair.
Primary weapon, okay. So that's definitely not the best choice.
Also identical insertion points again.
Try something while I'm here. Co-op, advanced setting, you know? Is it possible to... Versus. Okay. Advanced setting. Nope. There doesn't seem to be, setting for bot. Let me try something here. Go back to the main menu. Play. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I can just change the game mode to versus like you did, but no bots.
I'm just checking if there's an existing match going on.
There are no matches going on.
Oh, there is. There are. I found two people.
What?
They're playing Tango Hunt.
No. It says unable to find any servers for me. Okay, I'll join on you. Holy crap, how did you... It never found matches for me. I forgot the command to make it John Madden, but I guess it's not active anyway.
I think they removed that from the game because people were abusing it.
This would be... It would be the only fun thing in the game, so yes, people would abuse it. Hey, these guys are pros, gotta admit.
Yeah. They're playing Tango Hunt. Yeah, I was done.
Oh boy, we both get to be lag buds now that they're hosting as well.
I'm surprised that, like, everybody's playing it.
Yeah, I never found when I searched.
That guy, or I guess they saw him.
Yeah, that's a good use of lean, I gotta admit. No. Also, it seems they're using the walk toggle rather than... Are they crouched?
He's crouched.
I guess they're crouch walking, yeah. Real slow.
It's high talking. Bad mic?
I think the in-game voice chat is UE3 based, so it's always bad anyway. No matter what.
I wonder if it's just to push the talk.
They might be on like some mumble or whatever, but it's still transmitting sometimes in game.
Yeah.
We've certainly done that before as well.
I think the scale is off. The map seems to be bigger than the people, you know?
It's a giant room like something out of Half-Life where the scale's all messed up. It's funny to look at, you know, old, like, Half-Life era games where, like, you just got doors that are, you know, like, 4 meters tall and everything.
Yeah.
And, like, you can especially tell when you go into third person and see the messed upness. Because, like, before you had, like, Quake and that was all abstract and stuff, but once they started going all Half-Life and depicting real things, then, like, they just were not good with the scale for years.
hiding anyway.
He's running finally.
Yeah, I guess he got tired of it.
Man, Tango Hunt on a map this big just sounds like a nightmare.
I know.
Wonder if it tells you. It doesn't tell you how many are left.
Not as far as I can go. Sorry.
Okay.
Oh, interesting. He crashed before shooting. Oh, hey, look, it's that same room again. Okay, this map is just straight up Half-Life.
Raymond is a professional. She doesn't need to hear this.
Crates everywhere, giant reactor rooms, railings.
All it means is that the green tentacle is dispatching something constantly.
You know, at some point they're gonna fix fear or, you know, make a good fear-like game where you play as, you know, tactical special ops guys, but you're fighting monsters and, you know, giant tentacles from another dimension, stuff like that.
They modded fear combat to be like, you know, to have like new servers and stuff.
That's neat.
They used to use GameSpot.
Oh yeah, it did, didn't it?
It's a shame Tier 1 didn't catch on multiplayer wise. Or did it?
No, it never really was big even in the day. In fact, Fear 1 I think was the one where they pulled the trick of making a multiplayer demo and then making it free and making it compatible with the paid game's multiplayer because they didn't have enough people on.
Yeah, they were like, you could buy Perseus Mandate, but you're only going to be paying really for the campaign.
No, I mean, not even before the expansions, I think they did this. Where, like, just not enough people are on multiplayer, so they're like, we just gotta let people play it for free, so there'll be a population.
That was pretty cutting edge for its time, though.
Yeah, maybe that was the issue. I mean, just maybe a lot of people couldn't run it, or had the impression they couldn't run it, so they didn't buy it. Right?
I ran it on low the first time.
I don't remember what I had the exact time, but it did not run well either. I think, what was it?
I did end up replaying like Fear 2 on higher settings, and it definitely is a good looking game. Like, when you max up the settings, it's something about lighting and fire look really, really good.
Fear 2 had a lot of nice effects, but you really miss the stark, you know, Doom 3-ish lighting that original Fear did. But, like, it did it better than Doom 3 did, you know?
If anything, though, both of them look better, probably, than Fear 3.
Yeah, Fear 3 was not did not have a lot of effort in it.
Well, I don't think they had the budget anyway.
Yeah. It was kind of like a after Fear, how well Fear 2 sold or didn't sell. They're just like, budget developer, let them make a budget game, you know?
But Fear 2 was the first game that had like DLC that was gigantic. It had a four gigabyte 2 hour like DLC story thing.
Wasn't it the only DLC?
Oh yeah, it was. It was planned to be more, but you know.
Wait, you sure it was 4 gigabyte? I thought there was a hard 2 gigabyte limit on Xbox at the time.
It might have been compressed on console, but on Steam it was 4GB. At the time I was like, how is this 4GB?
Maybe higher res textures, yeah. My favorite thing about Fear on Steam is how, since they sell you in a bundle with the expansions, they just, like, the main game is copied over 3 times for both the expansions. So it takes up way more space than it needs to, but it doesn't really, I guess, mattered these days, because that still isn't that much space.
Looking for, like, one guy.
Yeah, the terror hunting on a map, actually, any of the maps aren't really that small, if you think about it. But this one is just especially gigantic. This is, like, a quarter of the Half-Life single-player campaign all in one, right?
They should port these maps over to Prince Floor 2.
You know, you're right. Well, this one at least might make a good Killing Floor map. If you can't cheese the monsters in that big room, at least. Yeah, maybe some of the others would too, yeah. Like the glass one. I think the biolab is probably too small, though. Anyway, it's great that we found a game, but this probably is not going to be finished anytime soon. You want to quit it?
Give them 1 more minute, and let's see.
Sure.
It's quite fun to watch.
It's neat seeing pros, but I think now that it's only one of them, it's not quite as interesting. That guy died like 15 minutes ago.
I'm waiting in anticipation to see like if it is.
Trapped in the closet.
I love my Beretta.
I guess part of the weapon variety is explained by the fact that the enemies all drop their weapons, so those have to already be modeled in the game anyway. And it seems like each map, the enemies have a couple different kinds of weapons, unique to the map.
This probably would have gotten more content over time had it been more successful.
Oh yeah, definitely. They would, you know, have loved to have been making a sequel by this point. Anyway, you wanna quit?
Yeah, it's a shame they can't wrap this up quick enough, because then we would have a 4-man team, but,
Hey, look, they're the ones who wanted to do, you know, find the last man instead of, objective or whatever, right?
Yep. Well, here we go.
He's probably hiding in some closet somewhere, I betcha. Okay, exit this. Yep. Anyway, thanks for playing Takedown. We can do more testing other stuff later. Okay?
I'll try to solo someone, because it's quite tense that you can die in like two bullets or something.
You die in a split second, and you also die before your lag realizes you're dead. It's neat. Anyway, see you later. Thanks for playing.